بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. Last night here in New York, we started searching for the ninth of power, which happened to be on the ninth of Friday, which is the best day of the week, and during the best month of the entire year, and during the best nights of the year, which are the last 10 nights of Ramadan, or could be the last 9 nights. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Udu'uni astajib lakum. He said, call on me and I will respond to you. And he also said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. He said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that when his servants ask about him, they asking regarding him, he should tell them that he is near, that Allah is near to the believer. And Allah continues saying, عُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ, that he responds to the supplication of the one who calls on him. Especially during these nights of Ramadan, this is when we should busy ourselves asking Allah. Allah's mercy is vast, especially during this time. This is when we should busy ourselves asking Allah for forgiveness, asking Allah to pardon us. That is why during these nights, the best dua to make is the Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. So basically, this is when you ask Allah to be pardoned. We all have sins. We have loads of sins. And this is when we ask Allah so we can offload these sins. My dear brothers and sisters, during this time, some of us are busy asking Allah for money. Allah is al-Razzaq. Allah provides for everyone, even the disbelievers. Among the richest people, the wealthiest people in this world are disbelievers. And it's not because Allah loves them more. It's not because Allah has blessed them. But this is what Allah can give to anyone without any measure at any time. So we shouldn't be worried about what we in this dunya. We already live in this dunya, so we shouldn't be asking Allah for dunya. We cannot see Jannah. We want to go to Jannah. This is when we ask Allah for Jannah, and we ask Allah for the highest Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah said about Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken Ibrahim alayhi salam as intimate friend. So why did Allah consider Ibrahim alayhi salam as an intimate friend? Allah said in another verse, إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, that he came to his Lord with a sound heart that had no disease, heart that did not associate any partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. During the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam, there were some lessons, and inshallah we're trying to take these lessons. Ibrahim alayhi salam was a child, and at that time everyone else was an idol worshiper. He was the only one. He did not read Quran. There was no book, anything for him to follow as guidance, as we have today. But Ibrahim alayhi salam followed his heart. He was the only one. In our world today, especially in the West, if you happen to be the only Muslim or among the few Muslims, you become nervous, you become very weak. You don't even speak against evil. You don't even speak the truth. You're afraid to speak up, And some of us, they even change themselves or they hide their identity not to be recognized as Muslim. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was a child. He did not have any support, any help, but he stood for what was right. And then they threatened to punish him. They threw him in the fire. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the fire to cool for him. And after that, Ibrahim alayhi salam left that town in search of another place where he can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, we as Muslims, we leave our countries to go to the Western world, the same places that we consider to be evil, but to go and search for money. That's what we worried about, searching money. Ibrahim alayhi salam at that age was worried about going to worship Allah the right way. So after that, Ibrahim alayhi salam, when Allah blessed him with a child, his first child, it was on a desert. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was following Allah's instructions. He was in search of Allah's pleasure. He left his wife and his child, a baby, a newborn baby, in the desert without any provision, no food, no water. But he trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knew Allah would provide for them. He was not worried. He went to go fulfill what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded him to do. And after that, if you look at in our life today, some of us leave our kids, we leave our wives behind back home to go to Europe or America somewhere to go in search of dunya. And sometimes we're gone for many years, all because we want to have money. We consider it to be better life. My dear brothers and sisters, Ibrahim alayhi salam was not worried about that. And us, we look for haram money sometimes. We take haram money anyhow, and we use excuse that we want to feed our family. You know, because of that, we want to feed our family, so we try to make what is haram halal. You know, but Ibrahim alayhi salam was not worried about that. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam, when they were raising the foundation of Kaaba, they were in hardship. They were under the heat of the sun in the desert without any equipment to help them raise this foundation. But all they worried about that, Allah accepted what they were doing. You know, Ibrahim alayhi salam was asking Allah, Rabbana taqabbal minna. This is what he was worried about. Today, when we pray, when we fast, we automatically think that Allah has to accept it. We don't even ask Allah to accept our ibadah. We think Allah must accept our ibadah. And today we think just because we are praying, we are fasting, that Allah has to do for us certain things, or whatever we wish, Allah has to give it to us right away. Ibrahim alayhi salam wasn't worried about that time he was living in. He asked Allah that Allah make the generation that is to come, make them Muslim. He asked Allah to give them provision. He asked Allah to give them security. He asked Allah to protect them. He asked Allah for many things, but everything he was asking Allah is for the future. He was not worried about himself. Today when we ask Allah, when we make dua, we only ask Allah for ourselves, and we only ask Allah for dunya. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِيهِمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرُجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ He said, in Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said, it's an excellent lesson, you know, example for everyone, for every believer who wants to meet Allah in the last day. You know, Allah made these lessons, whatever Ibrahim alayhi salam went through, as lessons for us to follow. My dear brothers and sisters, even today, as Allah said, people, when they go to Hajj, some of them are busy asking for dunya. They're asking Allah, Rabbana atina fi dunya. And, you know, asking Allah to give them the best of this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ That in the hereafter, they will not have any share. And there are some people who are asking Allah, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَكِنَ عَذَابَنَا They're asking Allah to give them the best in this life and the best in the hereafter, and then protect them from the hellfire. Because Allah said, whoever is protected from the hellfire, فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَا عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدَخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ That whoever is protected from the hellfire and made enter into Jannah, he's indeed, has succeeded. He's the one who is successful person. Because Allah said it after that, he said, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ That this life of dunya is nothing but a delusion. You know, there's something that we love, but it's nothing, will not benefit us. What Allah has for believers in the hereafter, in Jannah, is far better. It's far better. And just for a person to pray 2 rak'ah before Salatul Fajr, the reward that Allah gave him is what 10 times this world and everything that's in this world. Meaning, Bill Gates, whoever is in there, their wealth and everything, Allah give you this whole world 10 times of that, just for praying 2 rak'ah of Fajr. So imagine Allah, descend on this earth, that Allah is accepting dua during this night, Allah can give you much more than that. So why are you gonna busy yourself asking Allah for dunya? You know, some people asking Allah so they can enter US. Some people asking Allah, you know, so they can build a house, so they can do this. Well, you know, all these things is dunya. Ask Allah for the best and Allah will give you the best. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.